Masindi High Court Judge Jesse Byaruhanga sounded the warning while officiating as the chief guest during the free pro bono day for Masindi, which was organized by the National Social Security Fund and Legal Aid Service Providers Network, LASPNET. This was at Boma Grounds in Masindi.
Not like this. Since I entered prison,
he was reacting to concerns raised by the locals and legal officers while interacting with members of the judiciary.
As members of DCC and other CC, we shall not accept that. It will have to be sorted out.
Byaruhanga notes that denying the accused access has led to suspects spending more than 48 hours in cells and their files delaying reaching the resident state attorney's office, adding that the district coordination committee, which he chairs, cannot allow such things to continue.
Suspects should be easily accessed so that they are helped.
Dr. Sylvia Namubiru Mukasa, the chief executive officer of LASPNET, noted that the case of aggravated defilement, rape and land grabbing were the most reported cases by the locals during the pro bono clinic.
Under our project of Advocates and Frontier, and also which is funded by Austrian Development Agency, that the paralegals here find it very hard to interface with the police and also the lawyers.
She appealed to locals through their members of parliament to join LASPNET in pushing government to fast track the passing of legal aid law that puts in place the public defender's office at the district. Then they are paid by government for people to access legal services which are sustainable and state funded.
Ask your MP, what are you doing to have the legal aid law passed into law? That campaign that you are going to join to ask those questions to your members of parliament are going to cause government to pass that law and set up a public defender's office which will have those lawyers that will be sustainable and paid by a taxpayer's person.
Peter Mukasa, the community liaison officer at Masindi Police, noted that most people in the district do not respect court orders on lands, which gives police hard time to implement court orders. He also noted that the police are facing challenges in fuel for transport and paper shortage.
We want to be impactful on the community. We want to make sure that those who can't afford legal services can at least, as far as we are able to, be assisted through other strategic partners that we have.
The aim of the pro bono clinic was to provide free legal services to the marginalized and less privileged people who can't afford legal services at a cost. Report by Joseph Baguma for the news.